But first, in this special morning news bulletin, Julia Gillard will begin choosing her cabinet after finally winning enough support from the independents to hang on to government. Labor's package for the bush tipped the vote in the party's favour, but Australia is only one by-election away from another election.
Julia Gillard left her Canberra flat this morning. Pretty soon, she'll be leaving it for good. After 7 weeks of waiting, the lodge beckons. Tony Abbott came within a whisker of taking down two prime ministers in 2 months. The Liberal leader was gracious in defeat.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
The victor equally as humble.
That if we fail in this solemn responsibility, we will be judged harshly.
The lead-up to the crucial announcement from the three independents was just as bizarre as the unprecedented moments that came before it. At lunchtime, the first of the trio broke ranks.
I will be backing the coalition.
90 minutes later, the remaining two emerged. Tony Windsor quick to pledge his support.
I intend, with my vote, for what it's worth, to support the Labor Party.
Rob Oakeshott made all of Australia, including Julia Gillard and Tony Abbott, sit through a nail-biting 15-minute speech before this.
Give confidence and supply to government, and in effect, that means confidence and supply in Julia Gillard.
The clincher for Tony Windsor was national broadband.
I thought it was too good an opportunity to miss.
Rob Oakeshott thinks Labor offers more for regional Australia in education and in health. He's also been offered a ministerial position. But brawls within the bipartisanship have already begun.
We should have a great big swear jar in this building for the next 3 years, and that if anyone uses that word mandate, they should have to chip in some money.
I'm not sure I'm going to agree with Rob Oakeshott on that.
The final vote count is 76 to 74. That means passing legislation through the upper and lower house is going to be more difficult than ever before, and Australia may only be one by-election away from heading back to the polls.
Labor is prepared to deliver stable, effective and secure government for the next 3 years.
Whether they can is a whole new ballgame. Natasha Rexelby, 10 News.